Chris here again from Pronamics. With our resources set up, let's go over creating a direct cost schedule so we have items to price.
This is where you itemise all of the direct costs associated with the project. It forms a list of the items that you want to put a price on. So depending on what you're doing, you may think of this as the client schedule, or bill of quantities, or a list of billable items, or just the different tasks and activities that you need to budget for, whatever that is. The direct cost schedule forms the basis of the submission schedule, which you might think of as the most fundamental report of expert estimation. This itemises each of the billable direct cost items with sell rates and sell totals against each item. And these rates and totals include a spread of overhead costs and margin. We'll come back to working with reports later on. We're here looking at the direct cost schedule of the Wilson Creek Bridge tutorial project, which comes loaded with every new installation. In this example, all of the items are already priced up. So what do we see here on the grid? Well, as you can see, each item will have relevant identifying details, including an item number and a description. You can also assign a quantity and a unit. Now, any item without a quantity against it remains a text-only item. This means that you can have headings and annotations throughout your schedule without the risk of accidentally associating costs with those items. Items with a quantity automatically become what are called contributing items. Contributing items can have resources applied against them, which generate costs, which in turn contribute to the project total. You can also easily create rate-only items. These allow you to price up an item working towards an assumed quantity, but on the submission schedule, there will only be a sell rate displayed, not a total. Rate-only items allow you to offer priced rates for items which don't actually contribute to the project value. The information column here makes it easy to review the sorts of items that you have on the schedule. You can hover your cursor over the symbol to see what the symbol means. So we can see a green circle for contributing items, semicircle for rate-only items, sigma for subtotal items, and no symbol for blank and text-only items, and so on. To help you manage your progress as you estimate your direct cost items, you can use item states. Newly created items start as unfinished. And then, as these items become ready for review, you can mark them as check. Once checked, the items become read-only. So to make any changes, you'll need to first unfinish the items. The estimated rates and totals are also displayed for checked items. And as your items pass a final review, you can mark them then as finished. You can see the color of the text for the different items allows you to easily track the item states and therefore the progress of your estimate. We'll see where these estimated costs are coming from in the next video where we talk about the cost estimates. The formula column allows you to easily create subtotals for each of your schedule sections. And you can also use it to calculate the quantity of one of your direct cost items. And we'll go into working with the formula column in more detail in the video on cost estimates. Lastly, you can easily include provisional sums in your project by entering the sell total of your provisional sum in the provisional sum column. When you're first getting started, your direct cost schedule will be blank like this. So first, you'll need to create your items. You can get started by simply clicking the Add Schedule button here to add one item, or click the Insert Schedule Item button here to insert one or multiple items. While you can type out the item information manually to create your items, you can also copy and paste items from a spreadsheet. Simply select the multiple columns in the spreadsheet and copy. And then use the paste command in the direct cost schedule window. You'll see the paste special window. This allows you to map the copied columns of data to the correct columns in the schedule window. You can simply ignore any columns that you don't wish to paste in. Now the items are created, you can get started straight away. You can hold down the control key on your keyboard and select multiple items, and then apply formatting like bold and underline so your headings stand out. For the items that only require one resource to estimate the costs, you can estimate those straight away by applying the resource in the resource name field here. You can simply click in the field and start typing, and the pop-up list of resources will filter based on what you've typed, searching all the resources in this project's resource explorer. This allows you to quickly select the resource using the arrow buttons on your keyboard, and then press Enter or Tab to apply. See how the rate of the resource is multiplied by the scheduled quantity of the item to calculate the estimated total. If you'd like to see the rates and totals displayed for your unfinished items like you see here, you can open up Project Properties and Calculations, click on Edit to make changes, and make sure that you've checked this box to include unfinished items in Calculations. And that's an overview of getting started with the direct cost schedule. Now, before we move on to working with the cost estimates of each of these items, let's have a quick look at the overhead cost schedule of the Wilson Creek Bridge example project. The overhead cost schedule is where you itemise each of the overhead or indirect costs of the project. Although its function and purpose are obviously very different to the direct cost schedule, the good news is it's almost identical to work with. Once you know how to work with direct costs, you know how to work with the overhead costs. Each of your overhead items may be built up in the same way, with descriptions, quantities, and so on. And each can have a cost estimate behind it to build up the item's costs. The total of the overhead cost items will be placed into the overhead spread pool, which will be spread across the direct cost items proportionally.
And that's creating and working with the direct and overhead cost schedules. There is so much you can do with the cost schedules, and again, the ribbon toolbar will provide you details of each of the major features. In our next video, we'll go into the most important window in the program, the cost estimate window. We've put some useful knowledge base articles in links below this video. And if you'd like to speak to somebody, of course, give us a call on our 24/7 support number. And leave us a comment below. Either way, we'd love to hear from you.